Jungling just relentlessly counter jungles, even if he's dying. So
yep.
With Cinderhulk introduced and Nunu being unkillable, definitely like that. And they throw a second ban at him as well, taking away that Nidalee potentially in the jungle. So maybe a little bit of focus towards the Avant jungler.
Yeah, it does seem to be the case. Of course, I mean, Kensty was known as a Nidalee player as well. You can't discount that, but we haven't seen Nidalee in the mid lane for quite some time. Morgana, there's the respect ban against Teagan. Of course, yeah, Moya did actually play that as well. We love bringing up Fornut. This is brilliant.
Beat the Chiefs. That's why I brought it up.
Did he really?
That was the pick.
Was it Fornut that beat the Chiefs? Fantastic. I just wanted to talk about it for as long as possible. And here we are. We're actually the final ban coming through here for Team Immunity as we try and change the subject as quickly as possible. The producer getting very upset as the Gragas is going to be banned. So that's three jungle bans already.
Yeah, so really targeting Chovy. I wonder if they take the Sejuani here. They might be trying to force him onto that. Rek'Sai, of course, still available as well. That wouldn't be a bad pickup to come through for Chovy. Porky in the top lane, see whether he wants to take something like a Rumble. I like Porky's Rumble a lot.
See
whether that comes through. But really, a very open board because of what the jungle bans are.
Yeah, Maokai is available as well. I mean, the whole plethora of top lane champions. The Hecarim's there.
Hecarim.
Urgot is around. Sivir has seen a whole lot of success across all regions just recently. Could be an option that Warble wants to go for because, of course, a fantastic Sivir and Corki player is this guy. Loves the sort of short range, in-your-face champions. But Destiny, thinking about picking up a cow, we'll see whether that one is going to work out because, of course, Immunity will have two massive power picks come the next round.
Yeah, exactly right. So not giving much away there. Alistair, not a great laning. Support, although Ejim will have an argument with me about that, I am sure, at some point, but really is good throughout the mid and late game, becomes unkillable, gives you that very reliable front line, and they have given absolutely nothing away about their composition with that first pick.
Yeah, well, it's true. I mean, could also be Chelby picking up the jungle
definitely not.
Oh, you always break my ideas.
Alistair literally is one of the few junglers that cannot clear the first round.
Really? Just cannot do it?
Yeah, just straight up cannot do three games.
A little bit unfortunate. Misfitch, probably not going to be playing the jungle Teemo, but
I know there's going to be people out there that say, oh, but if you take full attack speed, I'm saying with a normal rune page, he very much struggles to clear the jungle.
I like how you have to defend
that something's going to blow up now.
Ryu, actually, thinking about Anar here, didn't see him play that too much in the last split of the OPL, but of course, Misfitch now deciding to switch over to the Nautilus. So a whole lot of CC now in the lineup of Immunity, even with a switch over to Sejuani, as this one is going to be locked in. This Wombo combo from Immunity is huge.
Yeah, the Sejuani now being able to scoop people into that frozen ultimate that can come through. Really a lot of lockdown CC.
Yeah.
Not to mention percentage health damage, something that's underrated in both Sejs as well as Narkit. Of course, that crunch, the upgraded bounce that you can just jump on people and do a whole load of damage.
Oh, the bounce crush, though, that's my personal favorite when you're just evolving and you get to do the double hop. Man, bouncy crush, so exciting. Yes. Don't look at me like that.
So
I can see
you. A whole lot of damage coming through from the ability that I highlighted about 10 seconds before you went on a random tangent. Kensty hovering that Sivir, as you mentioned. Warble does like to take that one into the bottom lane.
Yeah, and Chelby is going to be able to pick up a very easy Rek'Sai here. Fits his playstyle very well. Of course, Rek'Sai able to put on pressure all throughout the game. And Kensty is going to be able to pick up that Sivir for Warble. So I like what's coming together here for Avant.
Yeah, and once again, very similar lineup to what Chase brought in the last game. Very solid front line, although matched a little bit more in tankiness this time coming around from Team Immunity. And Cheese, I'm just going to mention Swain because it is open and he has some fantastic showings on it.
There is also the fact that Kensty, he's managed to lock in the Sivir, so they often play the Swain with the Sivir, making sure that the On the Hunt is there to get that Ravenous Flock in amongst the enemy team.
It's on the other team.
Right. Okay. Brain explosion.
Yeah.
See, I'm like so excited for a possibility of a Swain that I disregard what team I'm looking at.
Yeah, so they'll be able to run quickly away from the Swain as well.
That's true.
That,
well, I mean, with Immunity's lineup, they will be able to at least get a whole lot of lockdown so we can just meander towards them.
A much more relevant point.
Back on track, boys. We're going to be fine. Denian, though, back to a comfort pick of his from a long time ago.
Yeah, Denian was really good when Lucian had that change to being a short-range markman. Played the 40% cooldown reduction build before maybe a lot of people in the Oceanic scene picked it up. So definitely no stranger to that AD carry. Actually was very vocal about it still being the best AD carry after all the changes. So not surprised to see that one coming through. And Teagan, This guy's all about the hooks. I'm surprised it's not the Nautilus, but going with something like the Thresh means that they have a fairly aggressive Wife Steal bottom lane coming through
the
Atlas. Yeah,
the super standard Wife Steal bottom lane. We can't even have a smirk at that one because that's been said
just like
so many times.
Stealing it off you. That's why I'm smirking, because I knew it was going to come through.
Okay.
And important to note that Cheese actually has a cleanse, so maybe something like an Azir going to come through in that mid lane if it is left available.
Yeah, and of course Cassiopeia is banned away, so we're not going to see that potential matchup as Warble and Destiny are taking some time thinking about their lock-ins. The solo laners are the options now, and that is a very aggressive pick. Blind picking a Zed into the mid
is interesting. Zed Rumble, that is a heck of a lot of mid-game potential coming through now from Avant. They're a very good team fight, have a reliable split pusher in the Zed as well.
Yeah.
So we'll see how they tackle this mid game, but they have gone a little bit squishier. And now on the side of Immunity, with the two persistent damage threat as well as that beefy frontline, they've put together a very good team fighting comp.
Yeah, and a massive amount of consistent damage and CC.
And displacements. You've got the Flay, you've got the Gnar, you've got the wall that will come through.
Oh, the alley-oop potential from Immunity. The Glacial Prison, lock them all in place. And in fact, not even going to be happening, ladies and gentlemen. The last minute switch over to the Swain. Thank goodness, the first day and we're already in the promised land, Spawn.
Yeah, so Swain comes out. And I really didn't want him to do this because I don't know how Swain does
on
the
current
patch.
No, I don't think it's a better pick at all. I don't think...
I haven't seen Swain on the current patch. It does terrifically against Zed in lane, but that's only a portion of the game. They have very good team fight potential. Once again, a lot of damage will come out. And Swain, talking about persistent damage, is up there with the best per second in League of Legends. But there is just so many tanky members currently. And Swain, historically, whilst doing a huge amount of persistent damage, does struggle with mana issues.
Yeah, well, it's true. We'll see whether he is going to be okay in the laning phase. But of course, you pick up a Liandry's Torment, you're going to be doing a whole lot of work with that, I guess, Torment. Man, that's frustrating, the fact that Liandry's Torment and Torment have the same word in them. But of course, persistent damage, if you want that, you can pick up that item and the dot will apply that.
Yeah, but it's a lot of AoE that comes out of Swain's kit. So maybe not something that we will see. Generally, Cheese does like to just go Roa into
Roa's Zhonya's every single time, but that doesn't matter what champion he's playing. It has to be after those two items because there is defaults. He's going to grab those.
Well, Void Staff comes to mind. That's another one. We're running out of item slots.
That's true. Ravenous Deathcap has to be there.
Oh my god, we got one left. Spooky Ghost.
Yeah, Spooky Ghost and Boots, and then he's fine. So no room for the Liandry's Torment. We're not going to see that one coming out, and I apologize for ever even thinking about it. I would have loved to see the Azir, though, because, of course, you do get the option of using the Emperor's Divide into the Gnar. You get that alley-oop scoop move.
Yeah, I actually think that the Azir definitely fit the team comp a little bit better. Late game damage, we just saw it in spades last game coming out of Rhyme Master as well, so is a little bit more standard.
Yeah.
Does well against the Zed. You can shove him off you fairly reliably. Also has a relatively smooth build pass into Azonya's Hourglass, but maybe just wanted something that can match the split push. Of course, it's very hard to split push against a Swain because all of a sudden you're not concerned about shoving people away from you. You're just trying to kill them.
Yeah, of course. And of course, ladies and gentlemen, if you want to hop over to Twitter, let us know who you think is going to take this victory. Use the hashtag AVWin if you think it's going to be Avant-Garde, and use the hashtag IAMWin if you think it's going to be Team Immunity. Of course, I think that both of these teams, with the roster swaps that have come through, I don't quite know who is going to really be able to come out ahead because, of course, so much has changed based on the identity that they had in the previous split. We're going to learn a whole lot about what these guys are going to be bringing to the OPL this time around.
Yeah, I definitely agree, you know. Denian coming through there, a little bit more of a aggressive AD carry,
yeah,
you have
to
say.
Maybe too much.
Yeah, maybe too much. New jungler in the substitute position, Ms. Fish stepping up onto the main roster. So that's a big question mark for everyone. But over on the other side, you got Warble and Destiny coming through. Limited time to practice together.
Yeah.
Need a lot of synergy in that bottom lane. So once again, both teams have these huge question marks that we need to answer. AV, for me, have always been that thereabouts team.
Yeah.
With the exception of when they won it, they've always been about the third to fifth position, always very relevant in the last year of League of Legends. But on the side of Team Immunity, they're very polarizing. When they look good and when Cheese first joined the lineup, they looked very good. But when they look bad, they have some absolute shocking games.
Yeah, I like to think that they have hot potato syndrome. It's sort of like if they're managing to juggle the potato, then everything's fine. But as soon as it gets thrown, then it's over. And that's sort of a Renekton face checking a brush. That's what I sort of imagine it as.
Okay, I like that. The hot potato syndrome.
Yeah. What do you think?
Hashtag hot potato syndrome coming through here.
Let's not let that one happen.
I like that. That will become a thing.
But one can only hope, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah, and you know, they're not a patient team. I like that you bring up the face check that came through against the Chiefs, because that is very much a game that epitomizes immunity for me. They're this team that is very good. They get ahead. They're very aggressive. But then they do have some moments where they have complete brain fades and face checked brushes, especially when they knew where they were. And so definitely think that if they can get some reliability, that's where I look towards the jungle. Maybe Ms. Vish, Zahi was a very aggressive Lee Sin style jungler. Maybe Ms. Vish can bring that level head throw into this immunity lineup.
Well, we'll see if he can. Of course, Ms. Vish sort of known for being a bit of a solo queue menace there. It hasn't really seen too much professional play, but we'll see how he fits onto this immunity lineup, because, I mean, we're talking about the fact that they've had some questionable, overly aggressive decisions. Bringing Denny in onto the team does not change that fact whatsoever. I feel like the identity of immunity is almost well and truly intact, because with that trade out, I mean, it doesn't matter what Ms. Fish is going to do. I mean, Zahi leaves, Denian comes through. That's another YSSC member able just to go way too ham.
Yeah, so I definitely agree that it is a much more aggressive AD character.
Yeah, I love it. I honestly love it.
Yeah, of course you love it. You just loved YSSC, but we haven't seen Denian play professionally in a very long time. So maybe he has had a little bit of identity change. Lucian's still very much a lane bully. Across the other side of the map, you have anything but aggressive in Porky. He's like a rock. You cannot move him in the top lane. Very, very level-headed. Chelby, quite aggressive when you pair him with Kensty especially. They have some similar moments to immunity. But this bottom lane, I really can't wait till we see how Destiny and Warble play together. Are they going to be a passive lane for the first couple of games at least and just try and get some footing? Or are they going to burst onto the scene and really try and take some pressure away from Porky? Because I feel that there is a very clear way to beat Ivan at the moment, and it's take Kensty out of the game, because he does have some rough early games. If he can get to the late game, a very good team fighting player. And then just camp the heck out of Porky, because he is by far, for me, the MVP of the Avant lineup. A very solid player, fantastic team fight, really good decision making where he is on the map, and he reminds me a lot like Swiper, but then has a, in my mind, a better laning phase coming through.
Yeah, and also able to play these carries a little bit more effectively. I mean, he's on the rumble. If there was a highlight play for Porky in the last split, it was definitely on that rumble. He had an absolutely outstanding game on that champion against all odds. He was the hard carry for his team. You don't see that coming through from the top lane outside of Fantix, who was, of course, formerly Perfection.
Yeah, exactly right. So we'll have to see whether that is something he can continue, because definitely agree on the likes of Rumble, on even Maokai, he has very good games. And I just think that this guy really is the person you have to shut down.
Yeah, well, we'll see whether that's how we're going to see Immunity take this one, as AV and Immunity going to face off onto the Rift. Kensty moving up forward, and Denian right in the middle there. There is the man himself, the Lucian
no
player.
Blucian.
No Blucian.
I'm so sad.
Oh, Warble actually gets the auto attack down, but not going to out-trade a Lucian early. Yep. Both of those wards getting shot.
Denian could have got some gold there. He could have just shot him, light-slinged the ward, shot it again.
Unfortunate. He also could have picked up a Spell Thief's Edge for a little bit of extra gold. Gone back, sold it. Am I right?
Come out overall behind. Bought some pots. I have no idea where that is going.
No, nowhere good. Nowhere good. Ryu is going to have to get outside of the jungle, but got a deep ward there as Porky going to make his way back to lane. Of course, Mini now going to have a whole lot of harass potential on this rumble, but is it going to turn around in Rumble's favor at any point in this lane?
This is such a weird matchup, because everything on paper says that Gnar should win the matchup. He's tankier, he's got more persistent damage, very hard for Rumble to get in his face. But every single time I say that, Rumble solo kills Gnar. So I'm not going to say it. And I'm just going to say, in my opinion, Ryu should have a much better time in lane. But we'll see.
Yeah, we most certainly will see. It's Chelby starting on the bottom side of the map. Cheese just having to move away from Kensty, who's very rudely throwing shurikens at him before the laning phase has even started.
Maybe just celebrating the fact he doesn't have mana.
It's very disrespectful.
It
Cheese is on Swain. You know, he's an old man walking around with his staff.
Is he old?
Getting stuff thrown at him.
I didn't think Swain was old.
Oh, he's pretty old.
How old is he?
Well, he managed to take over from the Noxian general after that one came through, and after he died. I think Swain, General Swain, actually quite an old character as far as the lore is concerned.
Just wanted
he's got a really
age.
Cool first name, but I don't quite remember it. Dang it. It'll come to me. It'll come to me.
All right. As we see, Cheese actually zoning a little bit at the earlier part of the game. This is something that Zeds do struggle with, especially against people that punish melee to the extent that Swain does. And you see that he has started to shove the lane in a little bit, but Cheese in a fairly gankable position for Sej Wani early.
Yeah, Destin's going to land here in the bottom lane, though, as Denian is going to get knocked up from the Pulverize.
Ooh, and that's a level 2 versus a level 1, and all the damage went through onto Destiny, whereas Denian took it on the other side, and all of a sudden, a lot of kill potential coming through from AV.
Yeah, and as soon as they hit that level 2, of course, Immunity do have to very much respect the Headbutt Pulverize combination, as Warble now with a whole lot more burst damage in his kit available with the Boomerang that is going to come through. Denian now has used his potion. It's completely ticked through. He's only at half health.
Yeah, so Denian very much getting bullied in this early game. Has to use some mana to dodge out the way. Going to struggle to pick up some of the CS. No, very well done by T-Gun. So lane just shoved in, and maybe now they'll invade into Ms. Fish.
And Cheese, I'm going to continue clearing out this one.
Wow,
does have a...
Wow, that is so bad. Can Destiny steal it away? If he can, that is an absolute shocker coming through. Oh, he reset it.
Reset as T-Gun's going to come around here as well. Denian able to get some work done. The flash used from Destiny to get out of the way of that death sentence. And man, that was right on the edge. You have to give it to Destiny to try and get it away from the smite.
He was trying to alley-oop it to the Sivir.
All right. Miss Fish going to fall down as Kenzie, going to come through, try and steal away this blue buff. Is going to get it. Destiny gets his revenge in the end, and Miss Fish... It's a horrible start for this Sejuani.
Yeah, so they telegraphed that because they kept T-Gun there, so they knew they were going to persist to take the buff. Probably just should have walked away. With the purple smite, really don't need blue buff at the moment on Sejuani, just for wow.
Yeah, there's a Headbutt Pulverize onto both members of Immunity here. The Ignite ticking down as well as the Flay comes back. Chelby into the top lane trying to get this gank off. Ryu forced to use the flash. Teleport's available, can go heal up and get back to lane, but AV really making moves around this map at the moment.
Yeah, they certainly are, but Immunity, they... Maybe some questionable plays, I'm going to say, because yeah, they probably should have seen both of those coming. Immunity finally regulate, I guess, a little bit of the map, although it looks like Alistar still going aggressive in that bottom lane, and all of a sudden...
Yeah, Chelby looking to try and get in here. Nice never move onto Chelby as he dashes past using that tunnel down to about 200 health as Chi says, nah, you ain't ganking my lane, buddy.
Yeah, so Swain very good at turning those around. He's just got so much single target damage. It's hard to gank because of all the CC as well. And you see that Warble, he's picked himself up a nice CS advantage early, but Kenzie with that double buff might look to start bullying this lane.
Yeah, Chi's actually using all of his abilities and Kenzie just able to get the auto attacks down. Shuriken is going to hit, but Cheese thought he was just going to go back anyway, I guess. That was why he was going to use all his abilities on the wave.
Yeah, potentially coming through there as Ryu continuing to get bullied in this top lane. Once again, Rumble players unite, proving me wrong.
Yep.
He got a gank. Calling it unfair.
That's the thing. Miss Fish level 3. That is awful news here for the jungler of Immunity. Actually soaking experience in the mid lane.
They're bringing a third member. T-Gun wants in on the mid lane as well. He's abandoned Denian, maybe just looking to see whether they can gank the Zed, who of course, now level 6, that's a very dangerous play to make.
Yeah, and it's very difficult to do as well. So many abilities to get away from everything as Denian level 4 against the level 4 members of Avant-Garde.
That lane's pushing as well, so Denian, because of T-Gun's roam, completely zoned.
Yeah, there's another Headbutt Pulverize there, able to dodge away from one tick of that Boomerang as Warble able to get a bit of damage across, but... Now with T-Gun heading back to the lane, it might spell a little bit of better news here for the Immunity bottom lane. But
it's a pickaxe against double Doran's coming through. So Denian already seeded his late game build. And we said that Lucian, that mid-laning bully, being really dictated to. Now a gank coming through as well.
Yeah, there's another Headbutt Pulverize. He wants to try and take the Latin, flashes over it because he didn't think he could get there in time. Chelby gets Death Sentence. Nice play back here as well as Denian tries to get the damage through. But oh my goodness, if Warble had hit the coming back of that Boomerang, it would have spelt the death of Denian. Thankfully for Denian, didn't actually happen there as Kenzie trying to get some damage down here onto Cheese. But Cheese able to persist a little bit. He's down by 11 CS though.
Yeah, Boots 2 picked up in the top lane as well as we take a look at Porky. Wow.
Yeah, Descent's there in the mid lane as Cheese trying to weather this storm. Ravenous Flock is doing some work. The consistent damage of Swain able to at least get this one back here as there was at least some mana to burn from Cheese.
Yeah, so going in without the Ignite available, maybe a little bit ambitious from Kenzie. It is nearly back up and he dies.
Yep, Cheese is able to pick up that kill and never disregard the Cheese Swain, ladies and gentlemen. This could be the saving grace for Immunity this game.
Yeah, Tempname 507 putting on some work in that mid lane as Chelby goes in.
Yeah, little cutie Cheezeroni. Chelby actually going to get caught by Miss Fish here as well. Lots of damage from the Arctic Assault. Cheese picks up his second, and Miss Fish, some more of that experience. Don't know how I forgot the word experience, but I did. It is going to go over to Miss Fish.
Yeah, so Miss Fish able to pick that one up. 10 CS actually ahead of the Rek'Sai.
Oh, Danian. There's the last tick of the boomerang. Destiny actually getting hooked underneath the turret from T-Gun, but doesn't manage to secure the kill. And Danian, not a great start here to the OPL.
Yeah, and we asked whether Warble and Destiny were going to be able to be that aggressive lane to draw some pressure down there. I think they've answered that question already, going all out in this laning phase. And Porky is having a field day now, free farming on the Rumble, continuing to shove in there. Ryu not having the best of time as what should be a lane bully in Naren. You got to say, things going right for both teams. Cheese starting to get ahead, but really Porky being ahead in this mid game going to mean fantastic things for AV.
Yeah, Cheese going for his standard build here, his never move, actually going to find its mark onto Kensty here. Ravenous Flock just to clear out the wave. Ryu in so much trouble. Man, Porky is a monster on this Rumble.
Yeah, and this is what we said. If Porky gets left alone in the laning phase, it never goes well for the opposition because he's just such a reliable top laner when he's ahead. Now that he has that level 6 as well, look for him to use the equalizer, maybe get aggressive. Although Dragon also now on the table as an Avant. Got the Rek'Sai, they can start split pushing in the top lane. Double teleport's always a good thing. And Denian, you're in trouble.
Yeah, there's the ultimate pop from Warble. Flash into the Pulverize as well. Is Denian going to get headbutted back? Takes the Lantern. T-Gun for the rescue.
Yeah, T-Gun able to swoop in, save his AD carry, but not very much burnt for, once again, shoving him out of lane, continuing this bullying. Denian falling further and further behind. Now 13 CS.
He didn't have any summoners there. That was fantastic saving work here by T-Gun, but you're exactly right. It means that he still has to go back to base, and it's, I guess, they don't get the kill, but they stop Denian from doing any farming.
Yeah, and they just elongate this advantage that they're getting. It's getting bigger and bigger as Shelby's trying to take out the Scuttle Crab. Will manage to pick it up. Extra 30 gold with that upgraded jungle item.
Oh, Kensty not going to get never moved as Chelby's going to come around here as well. Nice use of the Torment by Cheesy. Wants to try and pick up the kill, but Kensty with that death mark not going to get the W damage. Destiny comes around. Cheese headbutted under the turret. And that's just a little bit too much. Unable to 1v3.
Yeah, in the end, a very good play coming through from Destiny. Looked like Kensty was actually in a little bit of trouble, but they pick up the kill, and now they're sending two members actually, towards that blue buff. And very nicely played from the avant-garde lineup.
Yeah, Denian, he's going to get fed some CS here by T-Gun's item. As nice death sentence. Oh my goodness, the flash pulverize. Chelby taking a bit of damage here at the same time. T-Gun so incredibly low, 100 health. Death sentence randomly thrown out towards the minion wave, but avant-garde not going to be able to pick up the kill. That's another really close one for that lineup.
But
though,
once again, burning two summoner spells, increasing this advantage they have in the bottom lane. Just so much pressure currently coming through from avant-garde. And once again, we're seeing the guy that's really enjoying this because Porky is having a field day in the top lane.
Yeah, actually Nard against the wall doesn't get stunned though as Porky tries to turn around. There's another flame splitter. Ryu burning down as he silenced himself. Nice Hex Drinker. They're going to keep Ryu a little bit more safe, but man, I wouldn't go toe-to-toe with this Rumble. He's pretty strong.
Yeah, he certainly is. Equalizer now back available after the Nard was used. So Porky definitely in the driver's seat, shoving in. Will he look to get aggressive? He's got everything available.
Yeah, I believe he's going to probably try and go for the dive. Chelby tries to get as close as he can with that Void Rush. As Rek'Sai is going to pay a visit. Ryu now at 350 health. Does have to be very careful.
Yeah, certainly does. Has chosen to try and back away. Chelby might be able to go aggressive here.
Oh no, does manage to unburrow. Flashes! Doesn't pick it up.
So he got the damage in the last half a second of the recall. So the recall still goes through, even though it looked like Chelby got the damage off. And teleport back into the lane means that Ryu won't really miss out on any experience.
Yeah, summoner spell for summoner spell there as the flash traded for the teleport, I guess, is what you could say. Porky does keep his though, so any plays around this dragon could be made. Danian though, again in trouble, just relentless pursues towards the lantern. To safety once more.
T-Gun's really doing a good job to keep Denian safe because Denian's trying his hardest to die right now and T-Gun just won't let him.
That is the Denian way. Is the Torment going to come through yet again here? Kensty takes half of his health bar. Cheese with a whole lot of damage available. Spell shield from Warble just to show that he can do it.
Bit preemptive.
I liked it. T-Gun is known to throw out death sentences at very strange times.
There is a wind-up action.
I think it's called off cooldown.
And once
Cheese
again,
solo kill in the mid lane. And
he's a very shy guy. Doesn't want to be caught out doing anything.
Yep. Wants to make sure that he does everything off the camera. That's when he's really going to perform. It is going to be the Culling Hughes there in the bottom lane, as you saw. Destiny does have a pink ward here, but Miss Fish able to create the numbers advantage. Shelby now getting pressured as well. As man, this is Cheese with only an arm guard's worth of damage and a catalyst.
Yeah, but the base damage is just so high. You throw in the amplification and Swain. This is what he's all about. Huge base damage coming through. That's why he can afford to go the mana hungry build of that Rod of Ages. And, you know, really getting some good stuff done. His team's 2,000 gold behind. But Cheese really is a saving grace at 3-0-1.
He most certainly is. Solo kills are plenty here as Ryu's trying to keep it together here on the top side of the map. Porky, if he keeps throwing harpoons in the wrong direction, IM might have a shot, but they are going to be able to take down the first dragon.
Yeah, so they grab the dragon against the Rumble lineup, not to mention the Rek'Sai. Very impressive for them to be able to sneak that one away. And that's against the flow, because you have to say this AV bottom lane going much better than what Immunity's currently getting.
Yeah, it's true. And look at the lead for Wobbly. 800 gold is the advantage for this Sivir. We've seen Sivirs be so successful just recently. Cheese, you know, with a bit of a minion wave stacked up towards him, going to give Kensi some time to roam around this map. We'll see whether he can get anything done as Ryu is going to head into that Mega Gnar form. Porky just faces his flame spitter towards him saying, yeah, come and fight me, mate.
Yeah, so Ryu needs to be careful here. You feel there's a lot of kill potential out of the Rumble right now with the double pen items. See whether they send any assistance up into Ryu's lane, because, you know, with Porky playing this aggressively, you feel that Sejuani might be able to have an impact.
Yeah, and Sejuani, Miss Fish, now with the Cinderhulk and the Sightstone, of course, synergizing very nicely together. Miss Fish drive by.
Well, this is something you want to do. As soon as you have the gold for that roller, especially if you've got an item behind it, you just need to back. So straight away, they get someone into the lane to soak the experience and just send Cheese back to lane. You saw he had the perfect amount for that Rod of Ages to come through, and he got it a fairly good click given the fact that he picked up an arm guard and boost beforehand only 14 minutes into the game.
Yeah, not too bad at all. I mean, we talk about the fact that, you know, 11 minutes probably a good time, but oh my goodness, Destiny with a phenomenal headbutt pulverize. There's a three-man play though, but T-Gun, he's going super low. There's the death sentence. Miss Fish down to about 100 health. Kensi picking up that kill, and AV, they turn it on.
Yeah, so two kills come through for Avant, and that is definitely in their favor for being able to shove out the lanes that were starting to, I guess, lose a little bit of momentum, as well as Warble now. Oh.
Yeah, Destiny actually, I mean, sorry, Danian going for the 1v1 play, coming out ahead here as well, as Warble unable to get the follow-up damage with that boomerang. And Scrying Orb going to be used. Destiny hunting for this Lucian and flashes. Oh my goodness, away from the boomerang.
Yeah, so a little bit of a
working the kinks out. Working the kinks out.
Just they're in new lane. We'll give them some time as Ryu try to sweep out this ward. Porky looking to go aggressive.
Yeah, Chelby looking to try and prevent that one though, as Ryu's going to get knocked up by that Umburo. Porky waiting for another flame spitter, and that's a pretty empowered one as Miss Fish here at exactly the right time. Arctic Assault not going to find Porky, but yep, here comes the Swain. Can he get slowed down enough here, though, as Ryu, he's only at about 300 health, does have a massive Gnar bar, though. They're going to try and go for something, but not going to get it. Cheese able to clear out the minion wave, but they're not going to be able to dive.
Yeah, definitely not going to go for that. Destiny going in again.
Yep, looking for it. Does have the mobility boots.
I love the Alistar run, by the way. It is one of the best things to behold on the Rift.
And what do you say when an Alistar runs? Oh, we're going to see this double. Oh, beautiful knockup.
Yeah, and straight away into the other one that came through there from Chelby. It was just so much damage coming through then from Kensi Zed. And what an equalizer there across all the members. But in the end,
that was his own members.
Oh, it was actually his own members. So, yeah, just, you know, if that was the other team, it would have been great.
It would have been stunning. He's just demonstrating the fact that Porky knows how to hit the most people with it, regardless
of
which team they're on.
Yep.
Thank goodness Friendly Fire does not exist in League of Legends. Otherwise, Porky would be the worst top lane to play run.
Tell that to Bard names.
Oh my goodness. That is Friendly Fire. Surprised we haven't seen all that much Bard so far, sort of this patch or this split.
Yeah, I actually think Bard's really strong as well, so surprised we haven't seen it come out there. Maybe teams just not practice enough on it yet, as Destiny, once again, he's flying around the map.
Yeah, going for that brush control, protecting their pink wards. Is AV able to even create a little bit of a stall? Because in the end, it is going to be Immunity managing to at least steal away some vision. Kensty there. He's going to wander towards the bottom side, but just cheating there at this stage.
Yeah, so the map very much normalized right now. AV with a 2,000 gold advantage, and that's against the flow with Cheese really doing a great job on Swain. Has picked up the Blade of the Ruined King in the mid lane, so maybe we'll see Kensty go towards more of a split push and draw Porky into the... Wow.
Yeah, he's on the hunt. Destiny misses as it's a beautiful Relentless Pursuit. And now Destiny has to use the ultimate. He's going to get pulled back into the team here. That's a lot of damage that they have to use to try and get through this Unbreakable Will. But Denian does have enough. Picks up his first kill of the game.
Yeah, so they burn the teleport to come down. Ryu gives up a wave of experience in the top lane. They have to go for the dive, otherwise it definitely was not worth it. They might pick up a turret, but Porky should be able to trade. It's only a kill for the teleport. Maybe a bit of an overcommitment, because I don't know they needed to use it.
Potentially not. Cheese able to put some pressure on here in the mid lane as well. They know that Zed isn't towards the bottom lane. Are they going to keep pushing through here at bot? No, they're not. Looking to transition to the outer turret in the mid lane.
Yeah, so they burnt the teleport. 5 minute cooldown for something I think they could have got otherwise. They get a little bit of control over the mid lane, but reality, someone needs to get top and sweep out that huge wave that Porky shoved into the turret. Otherwise, maybe a little bit of a misplay once again coming out of Immunity.
They did get a kill.
But they were going to get that otherwise. There was no way Alistar was surviving. Like, there was like five auto attacks that came through from Minina. He wasn't outputting all that damage.
Hey, are you kidding? Hyper does a fair bit of... No, you're exactly right. So, of course... Maybe he didn't need to head down there, but Ryu showing that he can assist his team. That is one thing
he's
that's fantastic.
He's lost a wave and a half top and is still not going there. That will definitely hit the turret. Only 10 seconds on the dragon, so you understand why he has to head. Why he has to head down there? That is so much resources now forced away from this Gnar.
Yeah, and Immunity, they really want to try and keep that dragon objective in their back pocket for a win condition here. And if they lose this one, the dragons are just equalized and they don't have the... big threat there of multiple dragons towards the mid-game stage of this one. Cheese almost with the Zhonya's Hourglass, probably would have wanted that two-item spike if they were heading towards there, but this dragon going down very, very quickly.
Just giving it up as well. Absolutely no interest in fighting that one, even with the advantage. And, you know, maybe because of the AoE potential that can come out of the Gnar, the Sejuani, as well as Swain, just don't want a team fight at this phase. Sticking more towards a split pushing strategy with Kensty in the bottom lane.
Yeah, Kensty heading down towards bot. AV do have Porky in the top lane here as well. Denian actually going to try and answer that one as Cheese just turns into a bird man just to try and let them know that, yes, I am a bird.
This is perfect for Kensty. He's got a Blade of the Ruined King and Yomu's against all magic resistant coming through from Gnar. If there is a split push situation that Avant want to elect into, it is that one right there. Get him away from the Swain who's now picked up. That's Zhonya's Hourglass. Avant push through in the mid lane, and Kensty, he's just going to continue relentlessly shoving in on this Gnar. Well, yeah. I actually think he can dive if he plays it right.
Yeah, if he can land everything there under
Four
Ryu,
members
he
collapsing as well.
That he can as well. No Gnar bar here for Ryu. Has to bounce away. There's the Deathmark. Shelby with the Chilling Smite and headbutt just for almost no reason. Kensty heads back out.
And look how much damage Kensty just did, and that was without Ignite and the Blade of the Ruined King active. There is no way Ryu should be one-on-one in that lane. Poor guy with all this magic resist having to deal with a mid-game Zed.
Yeah, Denian able to use the Cull and get a lot of damage onto Porky there. Never move just to clear out this wave here for Cheese. Is Chelby going to steal away a Grump? Tegon figures it out, but is going to be able to steal that one. Chelby
flashes
forced
instead
to
of
use
taking the tunnel.
Flash. Interesting one. Destiny, he's going to head around here as well. In fact, he had a bit of a knock-up, but he's going to be safe in the end.
Yeah, I like to call that the wolf special. He just gets left there. Oh, dodges out. Fancy footwork.
That is actually quite difficult
Moby's
to do.
Moby's kick in, and he just gallivants away.
Gallivants. I was actually thinking about this. What is the movement word for a cow?
Gallivanting.
Gallivant? Is that a...
Well, I have no idea. No, he doesn't trot.
I really actually thought that you were being serious there, as Denny is going to get critted here by Warble. Flashes out of the way of the equalizer.
Cheating there
a little bit, but nice use of the passive. Denny and one last auto attack, though, and Warble able to lock that one down.
Yeah, so they pick up another kill, and Denny and once again going a little bit over-aggressive. Didn't have the ward coverage to be up there, and they make him pay.
Yeah, the Infinity Edge was completed by Denny, but he had an Avarice Blade to... Actually, they were relatively close on items.
Yeah, he also had an equalizer dropped on him.
Yeah, that's the problem. Big fire line.
Big fire line.
Yeah, Band-Aid.
What?
There's a Band-Aid put down on the map.
Is there really?
Yeah, that's what an equalizer is. Does kind of look like a Band-Aid.
It looks nothing like a Band-Aid. What?
When it's that skin, it looks a bit like a Band-Aid.
All right, well, you have to go back and check that out. If I could organize a replay of that.
Band-Aid replay.
Yeah, just to check it out a little bit more. But we have, once again, Ryu going into the split push in the bottom lane. Really have to disagree with this. He's got two cloth armors at least, but I still think that Kensty more than happy to keep split pushing against Anar.
Yeah, Nah does almost have the teleport available yet again. Shelby's Raptor Sense is going to spot something out, but T-Gun trying to dodge away from the harpoons, forced to use that flash as a decent play to try and save T-Gun's life. He's used
ultimate.
The box as well. Destiny is going to get slowed down by that one, but immunities. T-Gun's just going to have to try and run to the enemy
base.
Meanwhile,
in the mid lane, they get a turret off this. T-Gun wasting a lot of time. They pick up the kill and some assists, but really, you have to say advantage immunity. Good rotation in the mid.
Yeah, pick up the objective here, and Gnar didn't fall down in the bottom lane there as well, as Zed is actually going to try and head round and stop the push in mid. They might be able to pick up a kill here, but AV, they've decided they want to take the inner turret in the top lane. Nice use of teleport just to save that one out, and it is, in fact, the culling going to be used from Danny. And I don't know whether nice is necessarily what I meant there, because, of course, oh, Deathmark here in the mid lane, meanwhile. Nevermove going to come through. Cheese does have the Zhonyas, but not even worried about dying here as Equalizer comes down just as an afterthought. Cheese flashes forward, uses the Zhonyas. The Ignite's going to tick down. Kensty's going to die. Cheese still alive now as well, but Miss Fish getting chased by Wobble. There's the On the Hunt ultimate going to be used as well as Wobble picks up that kill. Swain, in the meantime, couldn't stand up against the other two members of Avant-Garde, and it was a decent play there by Cheese, but in the end they do lose out the trade.
Yeah, so Cheese trades probably the best he could, but they overstayed in that mid lane, probably need to back away after they got that first turret, and now Avant shoving it in the mid.
Yeah, the boomerang battle here of the mid lane is Ryu going to throw them out as Warble is throwing them in response, but in the end, Avant are going to back away. Porky quite low there on health, and they're just going to try and sweep out the vision around this Baron yet again. You can see Chelby, he's got so many tunnels on this map.
Yeah, Chelby definitely lit it up, and you have to say the top side of the map as well with all those wards really keeping Avant in a safe position when they want to over-aggress in that top lane. As I do have confirmation that we have the Band-Aid replay coming through, so as we roll this one out, just...
Looks a bit like a Band-Aid.
That looks nothing like a Band-Aid.
Okay, now that I look at it, it really does. If I was
it looks
to
like,
wear
a fiery like a Band-Aid, chasm.
Yeah, if I was to wear a Band-Aid like that, I'd really question the Band-Aid.
It looked like something you wear a Band-Aid over, if anything.
Hey, yeah, maybe that's what it is. Maybe you need a second equalizer, and then it looks like a Band-Aid for the original equalizer. You've just dropped your pen, Spawn. Are you okay?
As a team fight taking place, please.
Yeah, okay. Cheese is actually going to take a fair bit of damage here. Porky with
he's not moving anywhere.
Oh, the headbutt pulverized. Cheese has to use the Zhonyas, but can't even do that. As Destiny's going to pop the item there, the Righteous Glory. Nice equalizer in the corridor, and T-Gun couldn't do anything. Decent ultimate there, but Kensi going to finish off the kill, and immunity members are just falling left, right, and center.
And once again, this is why you camp Porky, because you give him any semblance of a lead, and look how much work this Rumble is doing throughout the mid-game. Might even go for a cheeky Baron at only about 26 minutes in, because the three really tanky members, Ryu's still up. They might try and fight this, but looks like they're just giving it up.
Yeah, well, of course, that's every member of Avant. Three are dead on the side of immunity. Nothing they can do. They're behind anyway. 7,000 gold now the lead for this Avant-Garde lineup. And Chelby, we haven't mentioned him too much, but that is a very different situation from most Chelby games. Normally we're saying, oh, Chelby, why are you diving so deep under a turret? He's played very reserved, managed to pick up a whole lot more farm, mess with the jungle of immunity. He's played fantastically this game.
Yeah, certainly has. With that sidestone, really is one of the key factors towards that vision as well. As now immunity looking to collapse into a fight. And once again, Avant, they just give it up. They're playing extremely patient.
Yeah, actually, Miss Fish able to lock this one down. That's 3 dragons to 0 in favor of immunity now. And if they can keep doing this, I guess there is the opportunity to possibly get...
Nah, just flash.
Yeah, that was a very interesting use of flash. Wasn't going to mention it, but Ryu just wanted to catch up to Cheese.
There's no way
farm.
You can't mention it. At 25 minutes into the game, with a Baron buff, there's a very good chance Avant are going to siege right now, and no flash on Gnar means that they have no reliable way outside of Ms. Fish's ultimate to really get this one going.
Yeah, so a bit of an unfortunate misclick there for Ryu, as there is some vision available for Avant. I mean, if Ryu had have done that when he wasn't within vision...
Still bad.
Well, still bad, but at least Avant wouldn't have known. So now they can sort of push knowing that the Gnar isn't going to be flashing on them. In the end, Porky is going to try and throw over some harpoons, and they're going to try and get some sort of siege going on. T-Gun throws out another optimistic death sentence. There's now immunity.
Oh!
That ultimate from Miss Fish. We've been talking about sort of some optimistic skill shot placement, and that was definitely the epitome of that.
Yeah, it certainly was. I actually don't even know what he was going for.
T-Gun able to kill the siege minion that was a little bit too far out of range of the turret by using that death sentence. Very cute work.
But Avant, after having a 3,000 gold lead, now up around the 8,000 mark, as the never move comes through. And once again, it looks like they're going to be able to push through and take down this turret. Short range coming through from Sivir, but she should be able to pick it up.
Yeah, Kensi with the split push as well. That was a 4v5 in the mid lane. This inner turret in the bottom lane going to also fall down as Cheese trying to fight Chelby now as well. The Ravenous Flock doing some work. Never move onto the Rek'Sai. Rek'Sai going to fall down. Oh. There's the Equalizer. Miss Fish is going to get burnt to the ground. The Gnar into the wall from Ryu trying to get some work done, but Porky, he's going to pick up the kill on Sejuani. Destiny trying to get some work done here as well as Cheese tanking up so many minions, completely out of mana. Never move on to Destiny, but not going to be able to do much. And Immunity now have to try and defend against this Avant-Garde team. But I guess that was an even trade in the end.
Yeah, even trade, but they lose two turrets, not to mention the fact probably going to lose the third. So Avant break the base. Ryu being landed in, they might go for the fight.
Looking to pick something up. That death sense onto Warble was amazing, but the double knock-up and the Thresh falls down. Nice use of the passive there from Denny and gets him a kill. They trade supports, but they did manage to break the base. Inhibitor not quite fallen down just yet, but Immunity only seems like a matter of time now.
Yeah, so able for Avant to be able to take this one through, I think. But have a look at the replay here. Chelby a little bit over-aggressive onto Cheese, you got to say. That is a very fed Swain still, but the Equalizer was absolutely perfect, not to mention the fact that Destiny able to keep Ms. Fish on there. And Ryu, he's doing his best to zone, whilst Kensi just gets soloed out by Cheese. In the end, that was just such a good team fight from Avant because of how they're playing around the Rumble. When you have such an insurance policy in the team fights like that, to be able to split up the entirety of the team is going to be incredibly difficult for Immunity to take a 5v5.
Yeah, most definitely. We're seeing right now that Avant, even though Kensi seems to just die most of the fights, it doesn't really matter because Porky's just getting so much AoE damage.
Porky's 4-0-6.
Yeah, and 5-0-5 is Warble as well. As the Equalizer comes through in the back line, not entirely sure what it's doing. It stops the retreat of Immunity, but that is about it.
Yeah, all he was trying to do right there is create a zone where no one could help Cheese. He cut three people off around that turret, jammed them in that area, and it meant that Cheese was on his own. Once again, T-Gun coming to the rescue with another good lantern, but very good zoning ultimate coming through there because they thought they had enough to take out the Swain, but Cheese and T-Gun really are the two shining lights right now for Team Immunity.
Yeah, well, this is the thing, and we'll see whether the Swain can carry forward. 5-4-1. Of course, picking up most of the kills for his team. 5 out of 8 is definitely a large amount.
Look at the other side of the map. Warble, 5-0-5. Got the trinity of items he's looking for. You have a look at that Rumble. 4-0-6. He's nearly picked. Wow, fight starting.
Yeah, Righteous Glory has been popped. Porky actually flashing over the wall. What the heck was that ultimate, Miss Fish? It is going to be a lantern thrown out, but Immunity not going to be able to act on that as Warble's going to be able to split push there in the top lane.
He's going to take the whole base in the top lane if they don't send someone right now to answer it.
Immunity, what did you do putting your whole base in the top lane? Warble actually going to get piercing lighted there as Spawn shakes his head.
Thank you for that. That was great.
I needed the narration. No one else can see. Chelby, though, forced to use that flash as Miss Fish actually finds himself in an uncomfortable position. Someone wants to take the lantern. Stenian is going to opt into that one. Never move just to clear out the wave. Chelby taken down to half health. There's another equalizer, but not quite as good as the rest that Porky have used. But Miss Fish, very, very low. Porky going to use the Zhonya's. Cheese does use his as well. Every member of Avant, very, very low here. But the double kill for Kensi. Immunity now dropping like flies as T-Gun. He's relatively tanky, not tanky enough. Triple kill for Kensi. Now finally getting his reward.
Where
on this set.
Why did they decide to tank the mid lane turret?
Because it's there,
this
man.
This game is so confusing, from Sejuani ultimates to Porky ultimates to tanking mid lane when the free wave was coming in top. Got it all.
Yeah, they picked up the turret in the top lane in the end. There's no need to worry about it too much there, Spawn. It's 57 1,000 gold to 43, man. Avantgarde, 14K ahead. Now they've taken down their first inhibitor.
Baron up in 40 seconds. You have to think that's going to be the next objective. All of a sudden, Kensty, 7-4-5. He's picked himself up a GA outright as well.
My goodness. He did have the Negatron Cloak, but you're right. I mean, that was a huge buy. Also has a cheeky longsword there. Not sure what he's going to be building in towards. Probably a Bloodthirster with the Vampiric Scepter first. I don't know.
Yeah, I like potentially. I like Bloodthirster. I like Ravenous Hydra as well a lot on Zed, actually.
More active items.
Well, it means, yeah, if you go into the split push, you don't really have to use your abilities to split push.
That's a good point. 7-4-5, though, now for this Zed. Kensty really starting to get rolling after that triple kill. 4-0-9, though, Porky.
This is Dragon number
on
four,
the rumble.
Though, so...
Yeah, Immunity, they might be able to lock this one down. That Equalizer was insane. Immunity, they do lock it down, but take the Lantern, you crazy piggy. Cheese is going to get knocked up, though. Uses the Zhonya. Is able to get some consistent damage down. Ryu with a decent Gnar. Then the double stun with the Waller. But T-Gun getting chased by Kensty. He uses his death sentence to save his own life. Ryu, oh my goodness. That must be a terrifying experience. Flashes over the wall. Not sure why. Oh, wow. What? Is he going to survive? Able to get through the damage of the Q coming out of Chelby. But I don't know. The leapfrog play almost manages to get there. He's on about 15 health as he throws another boomerang. There's the last one. Preyseeker manages to get the work done as Cheesy's trying to defend for his team. They're going to lose the mid lane inhibitor turret. And if anything, Immunity have put on a show.
Yeah, exactly right. As they go in again, a flash burn from Warble. Destiny, you're in some trouble now.
Casual wander towards the left there is going to secure his life, though. My
I
goodness.
I have no idea what's happening anymore out here.
Neither do I. Thank goodness it is going to be pastry time and Rusty picking up after this because, honestly, our brains are melting to the hands of Kensi's Immunity and
probably
going to
die to Baron.
No, he's not. He's going to get Guardian Angeled. That's why he picked up that item, to make sure that he can't die to Baron when that one does come through. Some next level strategies to come down. Didn't even need it, but glad he had that one. It's Misfish.
You
oh
saw
my
the Baron
goodness.
Buff on Destiny. I am so confused why he kept going forward.
He'd clicked on it, and he didn't want to re-click, you know, saving the APM. Warble is going to clear out the mid lane there as
well. All right, so let's take stock. About 18,000, no, not that much. 15,000 gold, 17, around there.
Yep.
The lead right now for Avantgarde. They have some incredibly fed members as Kensty sells that longsword and picks up a BF for himself. So maybe the
Infinity can call it a longer sword?
I wouldn't. I'd call it a BF sword because that's what we name the item.
Okay.
Yeah.
Makes sense. Now, I understand, but I sort of like it.
The Abyssal Scepter.
I need to ruin my time completely.
Rumble as well. So they're in a very good position to win this game now with the Baron buff. They're pushing up mid lane, trying to siege in. Immunity, they're just looking for the Hail Mary.
Yeah, they're looking for something here as T-Gun does pop the Righteous Glory. There's the flash into the flay, but look at the Equalizer doing so much work. Death Sentence onto T-Gun. He's trying to get some work done, but look at the stun coming down, the shutdown. Denian trying to get things going on as Porky, he dies for the first time. Chelby going to fall down. Denian nets himself another kill. Lots of damage still available from Avant, though. That was a decent try from Immunity as a last-ditch effort to try and get back in this game.
Yeah, they went for the Hail Mary, not able to pull it off, so it looks like Avant.
Deathmark, wow. Kensty, what are you doing? Picks it up anyway. Fountain, not enough. Legendary in the end for the Zed that was getting soloed by the Swain. Destiny goes in for the desperation play. Not sure why it's desperation when they're inevitably going to win, but the Nexus falls down. Avantgarde pick up the first win of the OPL for them, and I'm honestly just completely at a loss.
Yeah, so Avantgarde really turned it on. Their aggressive bottom lane coming through, so impressed by Warble and Destiny down there. Really did a solid job.
Yeah.
Took it to Denian, who looked all out of sorts at the start of the game. T-Gun tried to hold it together, but in the end, every single lane really got rolling.
Yeah, it certainly did. Misfish also had a little bit of a slightly disappointing first series there in the OPL. I mean, not quite getting to the point where the Sejuani was being useful, but you have to hand it to Porky as well. I mean, he died in that last exchange, but my God, the Equalizers were fantastic. We have our first replay, ladies and gentlemen. Let's go over it, see whether Porky's Equalizer was good in this one.
No, this was a bad Equalizer. So when we roll this one out, Avant up about 10,000 gold, and
You see, they try and get the fight started here. Unfortunately, Cheese uses a lot of his CC, and they go in on Shelby, who's a very tanky member. And you see, Equalizer, not fantastic there out of Porky. And this is where Warble just takes over the team fight. You can see him on the back end, spell shields Zanara, and then just starts free hitting on the back line. Kenstie getting a lot of work done as well. He needs to stop deathmarking Cheese, though. Not a great target there. Probably should have gone for Denian at the top side of the screen. But in the end, there just was way too much of an advantage coming through for the Avant-Garde lineup.
And you say that wasn't a very good equalizer, but it zoned Denian out of that fight for its entire duration.
That was a bad equalizer.
All right, okay.
When you hit no one with a spell, it is not a good spell.
It did the first couple of ticks onto Denian spawn. Okay. It did at least something. But, I mean, of course, I just wanted to point out the fact that Porky did play that lane.
His other equalizers were fantastic. That was not one of them, unfortunately. But, yeah, his Rumble play really was good in the laning phase. Once again, Rumble should struggle in the range versus melee matchup, but able to take it to Ryu. That teleport really did set Ryu really far behind when he overextended on trying to grab that kill in the bottom lane. And from there, Porky was just able to really ramp up and become this huge threat for his team.
Yeah, and just played it beautifully in the laning phase as well. We saw him overheating and doing some fantastic stuff. We do have another replay, ladies and gentlemen.
I think this one sums up the game nicely because this is Kenstie as he gets incredibly far ahead. 20,000 gold, roughly about the lead. And if we roll this one out, you see that poor Denian, he's looking for anywhere to go. And that was an ability in an auto attack. And he died from full health.
Yeah, just flat out decimated.
Summed
on his
up own Denian's
phantom.
Day, unfortunately.
Yeah, just really needed that QSS or maybe any other item. Because at that point, just didn't have a whole lot. But ladies and gentlemen, this is halfway through the OPS.